Dear students, welcome to e-learning program. So today, I have came up with another interesting video. I hope you like this video and you will learn how to create a new smart application. So you must watch very carefully this video from beginning to end. And every part of the video is very important for you. So I think you want help from this video. And then we will know what kind of application today we are going to learn. So first, we are going to read question. The question is, write a GUI application, accept a radius in a text field and display the calculate diameter area and perimeter of the circle in a text area. On the click button, BTN calls. So student, this is our question. Today we are going to make a very small type of application. And first, we create a DOM and we have accept a radius. After accepting the radius, we have to find out the calculate diameter of area, perimeters, and circle. After click the button. So now, first we will go and design the form. And after we are executing this code, how to create this. First, open NetBeans. Open the NetBeans, you click on the file tab and click on new project and select Java Quick Apps and choose Java application. Click on next button and write your Java application name. So I am writing here calculate area. This is our project name. And here you can see if you put in a underscore or any special characters, that button will not be there. Okay. So you don't need to give underscore. Okay. After click on the finish button. This is our Java console application. So this application, this console, we are not using. So we are going to make a GUI from. So first you right click on the project and click on new and select J frame from. And after click the name and the locations. So write the name of the project. I am writing here calculate area. Calculate. Writing here area. Okay. So click on finish button. So this is our design area. So we are making design this from here only. So first we have to take a level, okay, and put in enter the radius. So first you take a level here and edit text option. And you write here, enter radius. Okay. Enter radius. Then, after you need any text box, so you choose text field and here you choose. So this is our text field. And after we need a text area. So where you have a text area there, so go to the AWT, that's an Applied application, and select here text area. And after you put in here text area and drag it. So this is our text area. I have already books here. Text area, panel, pop-up menu, menu board, scrolling, text field, so all the presence here. So I am today we are display the value inside a text area. Okay. So now need on calculate button. So take a button from the swing control. I take a new button and here take another label for with the headings. So write here calculate area. So we are going to decorate this form. First enter the radius. Look the properties. For change the foreground color. Okay, I have the gray color. Apply red color. Font. Size, I'm putting 24. And it should be like a bold. Okay. Now need to edit text area. First need to edit your text. Then right click, change the variable name. So I am writing here text field _ radius. Okay. Now this is the text area. So we should change the variable name. Text area _ radius. Okay. And the last, change the name of the button. So right here, calculate. Okay. Go to the change the variables name. So button sort standard is BTN or this. Now, we are going to decorate this text box. How this looks like after that, or should be bold and keep it for 24. Change the foreground color of the text. Okay, I am selecting blue color. Need a border to set the border also of the text box. After you choose also color of the border, I am choosing here. Click on. Now, change the properties of text area. Same background color should be changed of the properties. Okay, I am choosing the background color. And this is the RGB red. Green and blue combination, the color we have selected, that is a code of RGB concepts. After click on the font, how these which dialogues are putting 18. So I will say the font color also now. It is a result, so we can also copy and paste. So you edit your text. Here also into changes. I pick a different style. This one, bold, choose the choose the foreground color. So this is our calculation. Pattern also need to change to the properties and background color of the button. Keep on the background color. Okay. Need to change the foreground color. I selected red, deep color. Otherwise, click on white. So this is our target. Change the font color. Actually, font color is selected white, so it's not properly visible. The background color is not visible. So I say this color. So this is our form. We are going to make a simple application. Now go to the calculate area of Java and simply run the application how this applies our form. So student, this is our form. So it looks like very nice. Also has the project. So you can also apply different types of design. For using a decorative platform is the presence so beautiful. This part is over. The design parts I have already done. So now we are going to write the code of calculate button. If you are click on the calculate button after putting many things and then all the results come into it. Text in. Now, move to the next step. Write code for the calculate button and run the application. Now, write to calculate button code. So, you simply double click on the calculate button. This is your button area. Write your code here. And here that is a source code are present here. This is a design and say story and this is a source. Source code means here you edit your codes here. And private white button tell this is our name of the button. So here we write the codes to find out all the parameter parameter and circles. First we take a variable double. So double allocated 8 bytes in the memory. That is the highest fraction number in Java. So we are going to work out with the double. So take the variables R and how to convert double to a string to a double, because when the value is inside your text box that value will be converted to text. But we are using double, so we need to convert into a text to a double. So what is step 8? We are going to write here. Convert the text into a double. So we write double. This is our wrapper class. And parse double. T is always the capital letter. And what is the text box name? So in our text box name, how to find out your text box name? Control plus the space. Okay, then you write text text field. So here text field radius. This is our text box name. So select then which method use for get text from the text box, we are inserting get text. Complete. So this is the first statement. Take a value from the text box and store into a service. Now next. Another variables need a double. First, I will find out the what is the diameter means? 2 into radius. So 2 multiply into radius. This is a diameter. Now next, find out area. So what is the formula? Find out the area. Pi into r square. So double. Okay, that is find out the area. We write here dr. So we can use that math function in Java. Okay, math dot pi. That is also the usable. Otherwise, you can directly write 3.14. This is also the value of pi. So otherwise, we can write here math dot pi. Okay, into part into. Otherwise, here for comments, I am using comments. You can also write this statement 3.14 r square. Both statement you can use. Okay, last, double, find out perimeters. What is the formula of the perimeters? 2 into pi. Into map dot pi into top. So this is the formula of this. We need into top. So all the value I have already cut. This is the diameter, this is the area, and this is the perimeter. So all the value we are displaying inside the text area. So we are write the code of inserting value or displaying value inside the text area. Okay, so open source code. After you write here, what is the name of our text area? So write here text area of result. So which method we are is saying the value. So set text is a method, and we are using here script sequence, double quotation, and slash key using for tab. Okay. So these are many script sequence are Java. There are many script sequence are present in the Java. N for this is slash n. This is for new line. In slash key for it is a tab. Tap means this is much wider than space. Actually, this is called a tab. Okay. This type of escape sequence, it is called a from key. Okay. So these are the escape sequence we are using in our statement when we have to execute the code. These statements are executing on the run times. Okay. So there are many escape sequence, but we are using this statement, this escape sequence. So this is slash n for new line and slash t for tab. So I am putting here slash t. So it is slash t for tab, and I have just write the message. Diameter, actual key, colon, then of which variables storing diameters, t. So you write it. So after display the diameter, So another two colors also being displayed in the same place. So in the text area we are using append. Append is a method text area result dot append. Append and after if I think it is not a text area. Append is given. Choose append. After given string value. So we need here to new line. So first we are putting slash a. This is for new line. I have already told it. And slash t also here. Okay. After selecting area, write area and give column and variable ar. It will be text. That is the last for query. Text area. That is for reason. Here also it will happen. And right here only slash n and put also slash t. Okay. Use perimeter. Perimeter. Class. Which variables? Store the perimeter. So this is our simple code. Have already broken. Now we are going to execute this from. First, we click on the run file. Okay, and put it your radius. So I'm just write 7. And click on the calculate button. And you can see, after click on the calculate button, all the values are present and also showing in the new line. Okay, diameter, meter, perimeters. Diameter is 40. Okay, this is our area and this is our perimeter. So if you are not using slash n, what will be the value? I'm sorry, if you are not using slash n, so you have it slash a of the second line. Okay. Also third line. So you can see after the all lines are merged. So run. Then write here 7. Click on the calculator. You can see the value are present. A single line, not change in any line. So when you have to display with the same line, not using slash it. But if you want to, your value will be set in a new line. So that time you use slash n. So now we are putting slash n on new line and last statement of slash n. Now last time, what is the output of the following code? You see, using 7, and click on the calculate button, and you can see that our value keeps written here. And I've given tab, so this is the space for tab only. I have already left this area using the tab. So this is a simple area. I hope you students, you understand how to create a simple application to find out a diameter, area, and perimeter. So thank you for watching this video.